Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and I wanted to share with you the top 5 shortcuts that hopefully you'll actually use. Now, the shortcuts app needs to be installed. You can get this in the App Store for free, and there's a ton of shortcuts out there, but I wanted to find some that you'd actually use, and I did do a video on how to put these together in a different video some time ago, and I'll be making a follow-up to that later on. But this should work for you pretty simply. You'll just install them. I'll show you how to do that later on. Now, what we can do initially here is just go to our widgets. I already have the shortcuts widget here, and you'll see I have Wi-Fi off and on, Bluetooth off and on. So those four are going to be our first shortcuts since they're fairly simple and straightforward. Now, a lot of people were annoyed that Apple changed the control center when you turn Wi-Fi off. It says it only does it until tomorrow. So what we've made is a shortcut to turn it off and off and on for Bluetooth. Now, my daughter put these together. I know some of these are out there, but my daughter put most of these together, especially the more advanced ones, and they work really well. So if we'll go to Wi-Fi off, you'll see instantly it's off. And it's not just off in the control center, it's actually off right here. You'll see it's off. Wi-Fi is completely off. Now, if we go here, we can turn it back on. It will turn back on. And then the same is true of Bluetooth. Turn Bluetooth off. If we take a look here, you'll see Bluetooth is off now. So it works really well. It's super fast and straightforward. Turn it back on. And again, it will turn back on. So it's great, a simple way to turn that off and on if you want to, and leave it off until you want to turn it back on. Now, the next thing is a little bit more advanced. We'll go into the shortcuts app for this one. And the next one has to do with, right here, you'll see it has to do with morning. So we have morning and night. These are two separate ones. So they're a little bit more advanced. Now, on an Android phone, you can do something, say good morning. It's a routine that you can actually say good morning to your phone, and it will recognize that and then give you a bunch of information in succession. So that's what we've created here. So you'll see here's the program itself, and we'll need to customize a little bit of it. So it's going to give us our travel distance to wherever we're going. So we'll need to put that in at the bottom, and I have it going to the local Apple store. It's going to give us a bunch of information. So you need to make sure you have that set. And then I've also set the voice for this. So if you tap on these three dots, tap this little button here, you'll see it says good day. I customized that Siri phrase. So you see I can re-record it or delete the shortcut. I use that phrase because good morning's already taken. I used good day. So we'll close that and then we'll just say good day. Good day.
Your shortcut says today's date is November 6th, 2018. Your shortcut says the weather right now looks like this. 60.8 degrees Fahrenheit and foggy. Your shortcut says, you have the following events scheduled for today, Election Day. Your shortcut says, you have the following reminders for today. Your shortcut says, you are 32 minutes away from your chosen destination.
So that gives us a status of the whole day. Now, we don't have to have it read it to us like that. We can just go in here and tap on it, and it will open and give us that information. You'll see it run here. It's doing the same exact thing, and we can do that from the widgets as well. But it gives you the information for the day, and you'll have everything you need right there. Unfortunately, when it's reading it back, it says your shortcut says. So far, they haven't removed that ability. Now, the same is true for goodnight. This one does a little bit different things. Again, I've recorded a Siri voice of have a good night. So we'll try that one. Have a good night.
Sorry, there was a problem with the app.
Now, this is not an uncommon problem. I keep running into this, but the shortcut works just fine. So if we go into this, we'll run it. And it says, do you have anything to do tomorrow until you don't want to forget? And you might have noticed it dimmed the screen for the night. So we can say yes if we have a reminder. And it says, is there anything you don't want to forget tomorrow? It autofills yes. You hit OK. And it says, buy some, we'll just say milk. We'll just fill in what it already has. Hit done. And that's it. So it just asks you if you want a reminder, dims your screen, and you can have it set alarms as well. So we'll turn this back up. So I think you get the idea there. So that's really convenient. You have good morning, good night. And now we have another one that I think is pretty handy that might help if you're out in restaurants. Now there's tip apps available all over the place, but I haven't found one that does this. I could be wrong, but hopefully this will help. We'll go to bill. And it says, are you splitting the bill between multiple people? We'll say yes. says, how many people are you splitting it between? Let's pick three. It says, what is the total cost of the bill? We'll pick something like $241.85. So that's the total bill. Hit OK. It says, would you like to tip them? No tip, 10, 15, or 20%. We'll hit 20% and it gives you your part of the bill to pay. So it will split it up simply just like that. And you could assign a Siri shortcut to it with a voice as well. Tap the three dots, tap this button, add to Siri. And you could say something like bill. So let's try that. Bill. Now that will work. Now there's another one. This one's a lot more advanced and it's more of a bonus. We'll take a look at another one as well, but this is more of a bonus and it's really clever. It's activity and coffee shops is a second sub menu for this activity. So if we tap on the three buttons here, three dots, you'll see this is really quite a long program that's going on here. And so my daughter came up with this to take care of things if she was bored, maybe come up with something to do. So we'll tap on activity and it says, do you want to stay in or go out? So we'll say go out. And how much do you want to spend? We'll say $5 to $10. Pick something here. We'll say food. And it runs and picks the local food places nearby within a certain radius. So maybe we'll pick this one. It opens maps and then gets you directions there. So it's really simple and straightforward, but a great idea. And again, we can do activity, stay in, and it will give you a bunch of different websites with a bunch of activity ideas. Again, go out. And if it's in the winter, it will pick coffee shops. If it's not, it won't. So it does a bunch of different things. That's customizable, of course. You could say photo shoot, escape room, buy something. And they're all customized under this specific menu. It's pretty clever. And I really like that one. Now there's one more bonus one we did not create, and that's Photo Grid. And this is something that may help if you like to put a lot of photos together. We'll do Photo Grid and we'll pick all photos. We'll pick the wallpaper from now or from today, maybe an iPhone XR picture and some of the photos I took from the XR review. So let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I think that's enough. Let's hit done. We'll wait for it to run. And you'll see it's put them in a grid. Now this is a savable photo. You can edit it. You can save it like this to your photos and edit it and share it. And I think it's pretty helpful. There's some others here that I've messed around with that doesn't work so great. So those were more of experiments, but they do work. But all of these here that I've shown you now, I'll share in the description below. And let me show you how you can actually install one of those. It's pretty simple. I've emailed one from here over to that device so that you can check it out. So let me show you how that works. So here's the shortcut. I emailed it to myself. You'll get a link to the same sort of shortcut that will open up in the app. So we'll tap on this. And it says, what would you like to do? Copy to shortcuts. So make sure you have the shortcuts app installed, copy to shortcuts. And I already have it, but I'll just replace it. And here's the morning shortcut that we already ran. It's complete with all the information that we had before, and you'll need to fill in your destination. And that's it. So everything else, the destination's here, everything else should work just fine. You'll have that same destination as me. But once you've got it installed, you can just customize it. Tap the three buttons there, or dots, and customize the location. And hopefully that gives you some shortcuts that you'll actually use. Let me know of any good ones. If you have any others, I'd love to hear what you have to say in the comments below. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.